Tucker Burton, the designated hitter for the Mule Riders. 227 average on the season, 3 runs batted in so far this year. Left-handed hitter. Here's a shot to right field. Wind or no wind, you can forget about that one. Off the light pole just to the right of the scoreboard. And Tucker Burton got every bit of that baseball. And all of a sudden, it is 8-0, as you could have hung the Navy wash on that ball as Burton just absolutely killed it. That was a bomb. No doubt about it. As soon as it left the bat, a line drive that just kept going up. And it hits the light standard above the scoreboard to the right of the scoreboard, which is over probably around a 370 mark or so out there. And that ball was headed towards El Dorado.
And Burton puts a charge into that one out to right field. And it is off the wall, off the signage. And that is a 3-run blast with 2 away here in the second off the bat of Tucker Burton, his second of the season. And that may be the definition of timely hitting. It's a 5-run frame, 3 of them coming off the bat of Burton. And he is fired up, and rightfully so. It's a 6-0 advantage.
Friday and Saturday, and as you might expect when you go to Florida, nice weather on tap. 3-2 pitch. Swung on, drilled deep to right field. Ken Scott going back to the wall, looks up, it is gone. A home run for Tucker Burton. It's his 5th of the year. Run batted in, number 15. LeBlanc made a mistake, and Burton gives the Mule Riders a 1-0 lead. Kind of right up in his eyes. And Southern Arkansas with
home run, Tucker Burton. Now batting, the first baseman. Home run, Tucker Burton. Now batting, the first baseman, number 20, Josh.
Tucker Burden. Home run. There's really no other words to describe what that was. An absolute blast. His eighth of the season. It's now 13-8 Southern Arkansas. Five-run frame has cut it to five.
No score between the Mule Riders and the Tigers. Now Chitty comes set. The stretching delivers. That ball is hit into center field. This is deep, and it is gone. So that's a two-run home run here in the top of the first for Southern Arkansas. As Tucker Burton picks up a couple of RBIs right off the top. A two-run homer given up by Justin Chitty over the right center field wall. That ball went about 400 feet and cleared the wall by probably another 7 or 8 feet.
It's a potential tying run at the plate in the form of Tucker Burton. And he has 9 home runs on the season to go along with 28 runs batted in. Runner at second is Brandon Nickel. The pitch from Tack is on the way. Lifted out into left field, going back to the wall. The left fielder back near the wall. He'll look up, and it's out of here. Tucker Burton, home run number 10, RBI number 30. And the Mule Riders have tied it 3-3.
I don't know that I've seen him go opposite field all year. He got a good solid bat on that one and got it elevated. And, you know, he might have got a little help from the wind, but mostly that was Tucker Burton.
Yeah, he just went.
Welch really needs a strikeout right here, a strikeout or a pop-up. He comes set. Now the 2-2 pitch on the way. And it is swung on and hit high and deep to right field. Martin going back to the track, and he leaps, and it's gone. A 3-run homer for Tucker Burton. His 11th home run on the season. RBIs 34, 35, and 36. And SAU now leads it 8-6 in the seventh. Burton is 1-for-3 in the game. Burton singled in the fourth, flied out in the sixth. And that is hit high and deep to left center field, and that is gone. So a 3-run home run, the second 3-run homer for Burton in the series. He goes to the opposite field with that home run, and it is now 4-0 SAU. And Tucker Burton, his 12th home run, RBIs 41, 42, and 43 on the season. He now has 10 driven in the series.
Now batting, designated hitter, number 24, Tucker
the plate so far.
They are trying to get on
early in the count. Burton turns on one and sends it deep and gone over the train tracks in right field.
Goodness.
Burton's team leading 15th home run, and boy, was it ever a moonshot. Wow.
I'm throwing out a bunch of JC mascots here, but I thought you might know this one.
Gosh.
And I think you're going to, you know, be upset with yourself if you don't get it.
They're not the Coyotes. Oh, really? Okay. Tigers? Eagles?
How about Rangers?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, the Rangers, of course.
That one high. That one deep. Oh, my goodness. A second shot over the railroad track here at Majestic Park. We think it came down. There's no evidence that says so. Oh, my goodness. A two-run bomb for Burton.
Wow, well, you got to see it yesterday. I got to see it today with you. And now I can, not that I didn't believe you on the first one, but now I believe you. Whew. Did that clear the scoreboard, or was it to the right of it?
It was to the right of the scoreboard. It was high enough to clear the scoreboard had it gone straight over it.
Man.
I think it might have tapped the dot of the eye of Majestic Park, but I'm not even sure about that.
Wow.
This is the right-handed throwing, Casey Stewart. Stewart's pitch. That one is gone. That may be to the softball complex. It is up and onto the bridge out in right field. That was a bomb, no doubter. First pitch fastball inside. And Tucker Burton did vicious things to that baseball. Mule Riders. Solo home run by Tucker Burton. Make this a 9-3 ball game. Kind of knocked it toward left or toward center. Tucker Burton, 1-for-3. Lefty versus lefty matchup. Jacob Martinez at third. Ty Manning at second. SAU trailing by one. Huggins comes set. Off speed. That one lifted towards center field. That's got a chance. That's hit deep, and it is gone. Tucker Burton gives the Mule Riders the lead. A three-run bomb to straightaway center, and the Mule Riders have stormed all the way back and taken a 12-10 lead over the Ichabods as Burton is getting the SAU fans and team fired up. His second home run of the night. SAU leading 12-10.
That was a bomb.
Bottom of
the 2-0-2 strike count to Tucker Burton. Bilches comes in. Burton hits it a ton out to center field. Back goes the center fielder. It's a goal! A walk-off home run in the bottom of the ninth for Tucker Burton. Oh, yeah, he was due, and he delivered. He walks it off straightaway center field. His second big game-winning home run of the tournament. And he is fired up. He's still got to come through and touch home plate. Well, and there it is.
The umpire had to stay there with the Mule Riders jumping up and down to make sure that he touched home plate, and he did. And Tucker Burton is getting mobbed as he will send the Mule Riders to the Super Regional next weekend.
Inning. Seth Miller pitched quite a bit. That one lifted high and deep to right field by Tucker Burton. A solo shot to lead off the top of the eighth inning. Tucker Burton, home run number 20 on the season, and it is a 9-5 ball game.
Well, I hated seeing him coming in. You feel like he was due to hit one out, but you hate it in a leadoff position. You'd sure like.